That is why he died for you on the cross of Calvary. That is why he gave himself for you on the cross of Calvary.
My name is His Eminence, Archbishop Ambassador Samson Mustafa Benjamin, the founder of the Resurrection Praise Ministries for Africa Worldwide, one of the largest single-sitting congregations actually in Africa, in Nigeria, and so in the world at large too. At the same time, I am also the president of the Foundation for World Peace and Conflict Resolution, president also of the African Economic Empowerment Program. There are so much, but that's who you have seen on my way doing my duty of the preacher of the gospel. When you talk about congestion of traffic on Lagos Road generally, is always very, very high. But then the state of the road also adds to the congestion. I must say very vividly that since the return to the civil rule, the infrastructure has not been the way it is expected to be. Like, if you actually go to where the Resurrection Praise Ministry's headquarters is, that road was just done by this administration of the proactive governor of Lagos State, Mr. Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu. In fact, we are still grateful that he did that. That particular side of the road had never been touched by either federal or state or local government since 1999. It was only done in this dispensation of this proactive governor. But you know, the truth is, when you look at this road, you know, those days, these roads will be done, and the road after will be done, but that side will not be done. But the truth is, look at the way the road is right now. With the rainfall, right, you can see the congestion of the vehicles. If this road were to be smooth from Alakija there to this particular side, the roads are just there for you to see. So I will just beckon on the proactive governor of Lagos State, who actually bailed our own side out, to also look around this area, because there are so many state, federal, civil servants, both in service and retired, that lives around this area. A few meters from here, you will actually have the civil service servants club. It's there. I must be very honest that since the proactive governor of Lagos State actually assumed office, he has done some roads, not just that of the church. If you go inside a little bit, some of the roads have actually been done with the active chairperson of the Oriade Local Council, Honorable Ramota. She makes sure that those places are done. But the fact is, I think it is better to holistically attack the bad roads or infrastructure that we have in this area. Inasmuch as I say thank you to Mr. Governor and his cabinet, and I say thank you to Honorable Ramota, the chairperson of the Oriade Local Council, I will still say there is a great room for improvement. We need this place to actually, in fact, when before the lockdown, when you come, members of Praise Chapel, this is the largest church around the entire Badagry West, the largest. So you find cars parked on this way to the road, on that way downward. Some will also go into, you know, the closes where they have done. So I will appeal to the proactive governor of Lagos State, Mr. Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu, that you are doing a good job, and God bless you. And I love him very much for who he is and how proactive he has been since he has assumed office. But I plead with him to come and see the plight that is going on here. Now, one thing you don't know here is, apart from the Apapa Wharf and the tank farm that's is in that whole area, causing so much congestion, Listen, if you go behind here, the Ejegun water side, there are lots and lots and lots of tank farms. So you see tankers, trailers, heavy-duty vehicles that actually have impact on the road itself, plying the road. And you see them sometimes, they park, you know, double lane on this side, and they leave vehicular movement to one very small space. So it causes so much congestion. Apart from fixing the road, I will ask the, I don't call him just the governor. I call him proactive governor for a reason. 1999, till this period, we never enjoyed a good road to that side. He did it. And if you go inside, you will see some works going on as he's working with one of the, of course, elected official, the local council chairperson, Honorable Ramota. She's doing a very good job. I love her so very much. And I thank God for her life. And I pray for her. I pray for the state. I pray for the government. But when we have Navy Town, this is one of the biggest, the biggest barracks of Navy here. We have it here. This is federal government. And if you move a little closer, you will find the CBN quarters. That's Central Bank of Nigeria. Their staff quarters and their training school is on this road too. So I think it is better to actually, this very express road is good to be done as quickly as possible now that the rain is here. If not, we will continue to experience this congestion, number one. Number two, because of the hazards of the road, look at the rain and the water standing everywhere. Number three, the tankers and the heavy-duty vehicles, they create a lot of discomfort for vehicles and for traffic.